Hello everyone, my name is Saeed Al-Dhahri. I interviewed my grandfather and he was more than happy to take part of my assignment. The interview will consist of questions about the different kinds of food, the older generation ate, how these various kinds of foods were obtained, and what changed in our diet since then. According to my grandfather, our family used to be and still is interested in agriculture. We have harvested many palm trees, sheep, camels, and chicken, and all the resources we get today are from what my grandfather and his father before him harvested. Growing up, we ate food depending on the different times and seasons of the year. In the summer, when the palm trees are fully grown, they produce the summer dates, which we call it ratab. In the winter, the same palm tree produces a different kind of date that is only produced in the winter, which is called tamar. They also ate chicken, beef on special occasions, because back then beef was a lot more expensive than chicken, and it was hard to find. All the foods that we ate had to be rice and yogurt inclusive. The only type of meat that we would not eat yogurt with is fish. We have been warned by our ancestors that fish and yogurt do not mix well in the stomach and cause a lot of skin and stomach diseases. However, we ate chicken and rice almost every day. The foods we eat today are still the same as what we ate in the past. My grandfather claims to still be conservative when it comes to food and diet. Most foods today are mixed with many chemicals that could harm us in the long term. Therefore, all of our ingredients, vegetables and meats are homegrown in our farms. We do not have foods that we consider as our favorite. We consider all foods to be a blessing from God. My grandfather is a wise man, and although interviewing him was a great.
Hello everyone, my name is Muhammad. I am going to tell you about the different kinds of foods we ate in the past and how our consumption changed in the present. We live in a world that changes over time. However, culture and tradition never change. There are a lot of important parts of traditional, but the main point of it, food. Today, we still have the same recipes that our grandparents count it as a big part of their life. I will be introducing one of the people who have a big part in our family history, my grandma. My grandma grew up in Dubai, Jumeirah. They lived in a very calm, peaceful life because her father was one of the most popular businessmen in Dubai. However, as she said, Jumeirah has changed. It isn't like now, because in the past, people used to gather a lot, and there were a few houses. But as we'll all know that every century changes. Speaking of her age, I couldn't ask her because of the matter. I did not want to let her feel that she is getting old, and I felt maybe it is personal and she's going to be upset. My family grew up in a both rural and urban area because they have this routine. When it is winter, they go to a rural area. That's why are surrounded by green trees. It is the farm. She loves this place, and especially when it comes to the night times. They light up the fire and all family members surrounded them. When it is summer, they stay in the urban area, their town. Our country has a tasty, delicious food from the past to the present, but with some difference changed from the side of taste and proper So that's why we interviewed with my grandma, so she can tell us what is her favorite food that she ate while growing up. Some of these foods are khabisa, machbous, haris, biryani, belkhasaf, khamir, gemat. All types of food is still available now. My grandma said that in the past, the taste was different because the cookers that used to work for her were locals, as they were called before slaves. But as my grandma said, they were respected as any human being. Since the food was made by local, the food tastes different than now. Nowadays, we're bringing cookers from outside the country and teach them, but still she say it is not the same, even though the technology is developed. In the past, they used to send their workers once or twice a month to get their food and kitchen needs from the traditional markets, except the fish. They go fishing by different ways to get the best types of fish. Some of these fishes include gbab, nesar, jashid, shi'ri, hamur, etc. My thoughts on this interview is that how beautiful their lives before and how simple it was. How life changed quickly from the past until these days. And before, as I noticed from the interview, they did not have those fast foods. They were much healthier and they did not have many diseases. To sum up my thoughts, healthier food options is better for people than fast food because it is nutritious, full of vitamins, and it has many benefits that will benefit your body. And I noticed that oral food history does not change, even if in these days everything has developed through those
years. Healthier. We basically had everything available around the house and would barely visit the market that was hours away from our house. The goats and chickens were outside the house door feeding on the crops we planted. The herbs were spread all around and the milk was brought from our camels. The dates were brought from the trees that were planted by my father and his father. This also made it easier for us, where we had to visit the market once a month. It's where we buy or sometimes exchange animals and dates for sugar, tea, coffee, rice or medicines. This also allowed us to live a healthy life by moving a lot and working from sunrise until sunset. The food extremely changed. We did not know such thing as genetically modified food. It all happened fast and together. Out of nowhere, fast food restaurants took over, and I bet it's the main reason for most diseases now. It also changed our lives a lot. The chicken and meat in the market doesn't taste as good. Once you eat fast food, you don't feel okay because of the amount of oil in it. Also, fish is available in all markets today, but we would barely eat fish back then. It was so hard and it would never reach us. A fruit and a fish market are located in a lane where you could find many different kinds of fruits, vegetables and fish. However, we tried our best to plant and grow crops in our farms, but we barely succeeded due to the weather. At least we have our own date trees. We also get milk from our camels and cows, and sometimes make yogurt out of the cows. For the meat, we have goats and chickens in the farm. My favorite food was ragag bread with honey, and still is. I can never continue my day without it. All my meals need to be with ragag bread. It's the traditional Emirati homemade bread, and most people bake it every day. I like it because it's so light and tasty. Life was simple back then. We enjoyed it even though we didn't have much. We would barely get sick or catch a disease. I lived a very healthy life. I moved and worked a lot and only ate healthy food. In my opinion, the way we cooked was better than nowadays. It was cleaner and the herbs we would have are healthier. our medicines too. We had a better treatment for whenever we felt sick or got flu. I can't resist the fact that I want to try living back in the old days with our ancestors. From what I can see, is they had a great time even though it was a hard life, especially without the technology we have today. But old is gold, they say. I also noticed that a huge change occurred in food between the past and now. Our food today is full of chemicals and genetically modified. I was also surprised that they didn't know about many vegetables and fruits back then. I also found out they would do anything to eat fish because it was rare.